And I'm saying to you, when you look at Klay Thompson, LeBron James is at his best when the ball is in his hands and he's running an offense. You don't need another point guard that wants the ball in his hands. You don't need another big man to take up space in the low post or even on the perimeter. Don't get me wrong, that's not a bad option to have. But what I'm saying is, what LeBron James needs most is a sniper. Somebody that catches and shoots with a level of marksmanship that can only be rivaled by the elite who have ever done it in the history of this game. The National Basketball Association, you have a team like LeBron with the Lakers. The Lakers have been in existence, like most other teams, since 1948. 65 years passed, they missed five playoff appearances. Over the last 6 years, they've missed all six. These are the Los Angeles Lakers. What you're talking about is spanning history. Decades before I was ever born, and I'm 51, there have been teams in the National Basketball Association. And I am telling you, you cannot definitively find five shooters better than Klay Thompson in the history of basketball.
Or maybe any.
In the history of basketball.
Or maybe any.
Y'all truly do not, people, not y'all, but so many people truly do not appreciate how great of a shooter this dude is. And I'm talking about rolling off screens, rolling off picks, catching and firing away. Who better to have as your teammate than a 6'9", 260-pound dude accustomed to running the offense and creating mismatches as his specialty? No matter what you see from Klay with Steph, and Steph is his own arsenal because of his ability to shoot. If you were playing with somebody that's such a potent physical threat like LeBron, Klay Thompson would be heaven. LeBron James would believe he died and went to heaven if he had Klay Thompson.
That's a very good point, and I would say that Klay is in the argument for greatest shooter ever, period. Because back in the day, like Steve Kerr and these guys didn't have to shoot it as much as Klay. Klay takes so many threes, hits them at such a high rate. He's an amazing. Maybe
you can make an argument that the two greatest shooters
are on the same backcourt. Yeah,
on the same backcourt.
And for that reason, I think you can argue Klay higher than he ought to be. In other words, like Jimmy Butler is a more versatile two-way wing than Klay, who's also a two-way wing. And I think you can make a very strong case for him, but I'll take Klay over Butler simply because Klay shoots it otherworldly. Okay, but I'm not taking him over AD because Klay is a great player. He's better than a typical all-star, better than just a four-star player, but he's not an MVP. AD, when you talk about the best players in the game, and you talk about Kawhi and KD and LeBron, of course, and Giannis and Steph, and AD, I mean, AD is right there with anyone you want to mention. And the history of basketball shows you more than anything else. Whatever you think your needs are, whatever, like the Bobby Knight line, right? Hey, Bobby, who should we draft? Michael Jordan. But we need a center. Draft Jordan, play him at center. Whatever you think your needs are, if you have a chance to get AD, he's just superior. So the answer, and by the way, LeBron making plays and setting up teammates, how you like a big like AD in this day and age? That's your five?
Well, for me personally, I am in no way trying to say that Klay is better than AD. What I'm answering is who's better for LeBron. And when I think about LeBron and I think about how he wants to run an offense, it's not to say he wouldn't make it work with somebody as exceptional as AD. But what I'm saying to you is what LeBron brings to you in the interior, what he brings to you in the open court, what he brings to you in a half court while he's running the offense, whereas he'd have to sit around and watch KAD go to work, he can facilitate the success of a Klay Thompson. There's a reason that Klay Thompson once scored 37 points in a quarter. There's a reason why he once scored 61 points in 29 minutes, because Klay Thompson doesn't need to dribble and create his own shot. He can catch and shoot, and a marksmanship that he brings to the table. And let's also forget, we keep forgetting something about Klay Thompson. Klay Thompson's 6'7". Did y'all know that Klay Thompson defends four different positions?
He's a great defender.
Four different positions. So we act like, no, he's not AD, because few are. But we act like Klay is just a shooter, when in fact, he's an elite defender. And one of the greatest shooters we've ever seen in the history of basketball. So if you're talking about pairing him with LeBron, we got to take into account LeBron's skill set and what he's willing to do.
But that's what I'm saying. In the case of AD, you don't. In the case of AD, like if a team rolls into town and getting off the bus, there's LeBron James, there's Anthony Davis, you're like, uh-oh. Like, Clay is great, of course, but AD is a different level of
Well, how do you like this line? How do you like this line?
And his defense.
How do you like this line?
Not to mention his own.
AD with LeBron, yeah. Both would be successful. They'd have to sacrifice.
Yeah.
With Clay, there is no sacrifice.
Yeah, but I don't think they're as good with Clay as with AD. But I'll say something else. There's another guy on this list, Kyrie Irving. And Kyrie, his stock has fallen a little bit, but he needs to be with a guy like LeBron to get the most out of his ability, and I believe LeBron needs Kyrie probably more than Kyrie even needs LeBron. But they've already shown against your 73-win Warriors what LeBron and Kyrie can do together. So I would put Klay behind AD, behind Kyrie, but ahead of everybody else on the list.
I will say this. Here's the one part that you are ignoring about Kyrie with LeBron, and this is not Kyrie's fault, but I've always held this against LeBron. KD arrives in Golden State. KD and the Golden State Warriors are waiting for LeBron and the Cavs in the finals. LeBron and the Cavs beat Boston, and on the court in TD Bank Garden, LeBron gave what I consider to be a concession speech. He sat up there, looked into the cameras, and the great Doris Burke, the wonderful Doris Burke, the incomparable Doris Burke said, quote, you know what you got coming up here. LeBron said, I don't even want to think about it.
He wasn't lying.
I just don't want to think about it. I just want to enjoy this moment, et cetera, et cetera. Right. And what I'm saying to you is when you are that great and you got Kyrie, you don't give a damn concession speech before the finals even begins.